Yeah, I feel like losing in this doesn't feel that bad. The other thing is losing, maybe it doesn't feel bad because, like, most of the time when you lose as a killer, you just get like a little text pop-up that is like, you lost. It's not like you're like, I'm gonna win the game, and then some nerd pops you in your level one helmet with a car 98K from 300 meters away. You're just like, yeah, you know, congrats, you made it. Plus the winner pays for dinner. So true. So true. Thoughts on someone waking you from a nightmare? I don't know, man. If I'm 16 years old and I'm having night terrors, wake me up. At 34, like, my sleep is pinched. Don't wake me up for any reason except, like, the house is on fire or, like, someone is burgling us. If I'm having a nightmare, just let me sleep, man. Nobody do a job right but me around here. I don't know the damn map. No first. Oh, I know the map. What if Tomo's having a hairball? No, there's definitely times like I wake up 3 a.m. and I hear like yak, 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 yak. And it's not the old guy from the Skype laugh compilation coming to my house. It's a cat throwing up. And if it's in the bedroom, on average, I will wake up and clean it. If it's anywhere else in the house, I'm like, that's tomorrow's problem. When the cat throws up on the kitchen floor, that's all tomorrow's problems. You know what I'm saying? If Ruka yaks a hairball by the door, that's all tomorrow's problems. Sitar playing intensifies. Thoughts on Dave Matthews? I don't like him as an artist. But as usual, every year, Peloton has a quote-unquote music festival. And they get 30 artists I've never heard of and 4 that I don't like. And they just release exclusively content that features their music. And Dave Matthews Band is one of the only artists that I know when I looked at the list of artists that were in the festival. So I don't know, I don't think I can do a 30-minute Lovewell, Emma Lovewell, Dave Matthews Band Crash Into Me ride. Why would you say? Here's what I would say about Dave Matthews and his band. Holy cow, they're on the next floor already. I think in any 30-minute Peloton ride or any 30-minute experience in general, I could handle one Dave Matthews Band song and be pleased. I would be like, you know what? This Dave Matthews guy has kind of got it figured out. Stop it! But if I had to listen to a second one right after it, I would turn off my bike. I'm not blind. I'm trying to take the pincer on this one. Now, I didn't exactly crush it from a pincer standpoint, obviously, but I think they were coming up this door right here. I guess what I would say, to put it as glibly as possible, is I never want to hear 2 Dave Matthews songs in a row. Now, how is that for an attack?
It's gonna be much more for the worse if the others find you. I promise you that.
I never want to hear one in a row. See, that's just rude. I feel like one song is okay. One song's okay. I'm trying to think of what's the other... I know what would you say. I know where are you going. I know Gravedigger. Wow, good swinging. Another base! That's fine. I mean, I whiff too. I can't be mad. Can't be mad. Ants marching. Ants marching is the one that goes wham, 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 wham. Is that one, right? What's the one that goes, hey, it's my birthday? That's what would you say yet again. What would you say? The lyrics be like the ants go marching one by one. Hurrah. Hurrah. Huzzah, huzzah. The ants go marching two by two, huzzah. Well, they basically just crushed us this time. Can somebody, by the, okay, that was, holy cow. Somebody needs to look up the Peloton, just Google Peloton All for One Festival 2023. There will be an article from a website called Pelo Buddy. Click on that and then see how many artists in there you know. Well, you know what? The queue times in this game are like 90 seconds long. So we have plenty of time. By the way, hello, Jay. Peloton All for One 2023 schedule. Number one article, one Peloton. We skip that. We go to PeloBuddy.com. Wait, this is last year's. You've screwed me, Pelo Buddy. 2023. No, the page doesn't exist. Okay, well, I'm here we go. I'm going to Peloton. I'm going to the official Peloton website. Okay. I've rejected all of your cookies. You can get enough of my data. This is 2022, man. Where's the 2023 article? This page doesn't exist. Classes. Buy the bike, buy the merchandise. Where's the blog, brother? Where's the blog? Peloton, a Google Pelo Buddy directly. I forgot, Google's bad now. Okay, here we go. Used to be faster to just go to Google. Now it's faster if you know the website. It's faster to go to the website. They screwed it up, man. They screwed it up. Okay, hang on. The list of live classes became available. The full lineup was revealed on August 22nd. Ready? Armin van Buuren. I know that he's a disc jockey. Betty Who? I simply don't know them. The Black Keys? I really don't want to take that ride. I got nothing against them, but I just, much like the Dave Matthews Band, I don't want to hear two Black Keys songs back to back. Chaka Khan? If that's Ali Love or Cody Rigsby, I'll take that ride. Chris Stapleton, don't know them. City Girls, don't know them. Dave, don't know them. Dave Matthews Band, I know them. I probably won't take the ride. Eagles, if that's a Christine Dercole ride, I'm not going to take it. If it's a, if it's an Emma Lovewell ride, I will take it. Ellie Goulding, I'm not taking that ride. I'm sorry. It's just not my tempo. Felix Jane, I don't know them. FKJ, I don't know them. Hozier, I don't know them. Kali Uchis, I don't know them. Katy Perry, I will be taking that ride, 100%. The Kid Laroi, I won't be taking that one. Well, I don't really know who it is. LL Cool J, I'll probably take that one. LP Giobi, I don't know them. Gorillaz, I'll probably take that ride. Machine Gun Kelly, I will not be taking that ride. Marin Morris, I will not be taking that ride. The only song I know from her is Oops Whoops Wait Aha from Sesame Street. Metro Boomin, I don't know them. Miguel, don't know them. Pusha T, I'll take that ride. Raul Alejandro, don't know them. Ray, don't know them. Rema, don't know them. Salt and Peppa, I will be taking that ride. Sampha, I don't know them. Skrillex, I will not be taking that ride. 30 Seconds to Mars, I will not be taking that ride. ZZ Top, I probably won't be taking that ride. Really said ready TF up. And the worst part is they're right. You're taking that ride. I'm not taking that ride. You can't break these cuffs. I'm loving the strong colored shirt rotation. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. And Jay, if you thought you loved it before, how about now? I think that my sister-in-law caught the vibe that she kind of overdid it with the two big pots of Korean soup showing up at our house at 11 p.m. And then we took both of her kids to Disney World for a week. Connie is very upset. Have you noticed this? So when she came to drop off her kids at our house 2 days ago, she brought us, she got a big like bullseye horse doll from Toy Story for our daughter. She had a Disney shirt for my wife and myself. Now, it says something about my relationship with my sister-in-law that she thinks I'm in love with the Disney Corporation. I can understand why she would get that vibe, but it's a cute shirt either way. I'm happy to be wearing it. And also, my wife's got a lot of Disney merch, so we get a cute couples matching thing when we're outside. Is she wrong? Well, I really like the theme parks and their resorts. The movies, not so much. You did want to buy Lorcana? Yeah, but that's not because it had like Elsa. That's because of the fact that there's something deep inside of the human brain that's like, there's EV to be mined, right? I don't think we don't padlock this one. I'm gonna remove the padlock. Thanks, brother. Seems insane to me that someone would go to Disney World and then just buy a Disney shirt. It seems insane to me that you would buy a shirt from Tommy Hilfiger, even though you've never met the man. So, like, you know, let's let those of us not in glass houses throw stones, okay? It's funny, your shirt says Tommy Hilfiger on it, but I don't believe you've ever met the man. Is your name Tommy Hilfiger? I don't think so. And yet here you are with his name on your chest. Brother, you gotta get the hell out of here, Tommy. Johnny, whatever. Mr. H. I'm wearing your NL merch right now. Hey, that's an exception. It's funny to visit Arizona and then you see people that are wearing a shirt that says like Arizona and it has like a sunset on it. I mean, I think I get accused of being judgmental and I believe that I am judgmental. But I think the thing is, you're also like as judgmental as me, you're just not as good at it. Like, why are you ragging on people for wearing a shirt with the name of a place that they've been on it? That's like very, within the spectrum of human behavior, that's beyond normal. It's extremely common. My ass is more getting rankled by people that like go to an ice cream store and they're like, hey, can I get a sample of Tahitian vanilla? And I'm like, little bro, you don't know what vanilla ice cream tastes like? We all know you're gonna order the salted caramel anyway, so like why are you making the lineup take so long to get through? I have, maybe this might strike you as an insane take. Here's my rule. My ice cream shop would go out of business. I'm glad that I'm not in an ice cream store, in the ice cream business. I saw them, not blind. I saw they're working together. Guys, over here! He's gonna barrel me. I'm gonna bait the barrel. That's free blood, as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, Leatherface, get him! No, I'm gonna, because he might double back and go for the door. That should be Leatherface's kill without a doubt. I feel like someone's getting chopped up here, and that's wonderful news for us. And a disconnected. We got a gravity assist on that one for sure. The rule at my ice cream shop, if you take a sample of something, you have to order something you sampled. You don't get to take three samples and then order something that you didn't sample before, okay? Now, I'm not suggesting if you take one sample, you're locked in. You can take up to three ice cream samples, but your full order must be the best of the three things that you sampled. You don't get to be like, give me a bunch of free ice cream and then I'm just gonna take the usual. You're wasting everybody's time, okay? Who's sampling ice cream? Everybody in front of me in line at Salt and Straw. Jay, tell me I'm wrong on this one. If there's no queue, that wouldn't happen because my ice cream is to die for. There would always be a queue. When were you there last? When I was at Disney Springs. I went to... I'm catching a lot of flack today. If you're going through hell, keep going. That's what I've always said. Me and Winston Churchill, I think. One of the few things I agree with Winston Churchill on. Also, saying that Adolf Hitler was a bad guy. Those are the two big ones, I would say. I saw someone get through here. We went to Salt and Straw at Disney Springs. And don't get me wrong. This was good ice cream. But it was not the best ice... Oh, you're going to make it. I'm going to say congratulations to you. Oh, maybe... I think you're still going to make it. I'm Stamless in Seattle. It was not as good as I thought it would be, given both the price, the weight, and the location. It was not... The Salt and Straw was good, but it was not the best ice cream I've ever had. What flavor did you get? I don't know, it's some caramel swizzle or something like that. It was... I don't remember specifically. It was called Glizzy Overdrive. And there are going to be people here that are Vancouver-pilled. If you want to ask, if you want to get into an argument with a Vancouverite, there's three foods you could, well, there's probably like 10 foods you could ask them about because we're a conflict-oriented people. One would be sushi. One would be donuts. We've already talked about our donut preferences. Another one would be ice cream. There's a big debate over the best ice cream in Vancouver right now. I personally am an Ernest ice cream stan, even though it's fucked up that it takes like... You could be waiting in line for like 45 minutes for a scoop of ice cream on a hot summer day. But that's because it hits the spot, right? Rain or shine? I'm not against it. It's a generator. I'm not against it. Dolce Amore beat Ernest easy. I never went because they were located in Kitsilano. And I'm simply not that guy. I'm not a Kits guy, okay? You can read it on my face. I'm not a Kitsilano Andy. It's on commercial? Oh, never mind. I'm not a commercial Andy either. For a while, I thought I was a commercial drive Andy. And then I know I told the story. We're not doing amazing as the killer here, but... I was on commercial drive. I forget what I think I was eating some... I ate a burrito from... Sally Limon, and I was like, this is pretty good. Was it worth the walk? Yeah, but not by much. But it was worth it. But either way, sorry, I got sidetracked. What was I talking about? I blacked out for a second. I was on Commercial Drive. I walked past the BC liquor store on Commercial Drive, and a 45-year-old man in a backwards basketball hat came up to me and went, "Elbow smash!"
and like faked that he was gonna elbow me in the stomach. And you know, it's not the first time I've experienced something like that in the city. So I kind of laughed as if I'm cool. And I went, "Hi, you had me going for a second there." Or I said like, "Oh, you scared me." And then there was a dude walking behind me who said, "You got to be careful playing games like this out here, man. It's bad for your health." Now, he wasn't saying that to me. He was saying it to the elbow smash dude. So I just kept walking. But then the elbow smash dude and the dude who replied to the elbow smash dude started having like almost a nose-to-nose conversation. And I'm like, I'm gone. This is the generator, isn't it? No, it's not. It is. Where's grandfather? Grandpa? Oh, there he is. Anyway, everything was fine. Dude was right, though. That guy's gonna get hit. Brother, both of these guys were the guys doing the hitting. This was not like a 45-year-old father of three that was just doing some goofing out on the sidewalk. This was an insane person encountering another insane person. You got somebody, brother? No? Okay. All right. Least favorite Vancouver neighborhood? Somebody replied Gastown. I gotta give you a +2 on that one. Gastown, run down, and there's a lot of parts of Vancouver that are a little spicy. Gastown is amongst the spiciest, but most of the parts that are a little spicy, at the very least, have great... I see them. I just taken the long way home. At least have great restaurants. Vancouver, or Gastown, does not have good enough restaurants to justify how spicy it is down there. I'll go down to Chinatown. I'll go get some Bao Bay. I'll go to Phnom Penh and get some butter beef or something like that. That doesn't bother me in the slightest. I am not going to Gastown, walking down 10 blocks that smell like piss, having my window smashed to eat at the old spaghetti factory? The old spaghetti factory? Are you crazy? It's simply not happening. Gastown's all tourists looking at the steam clock like the Zerg. Steam clock is very funny. I'm always, listen, because the older I've gotten, the more I've been like, stop getting annoyed by tourists. They're literally just on vacation. Like when I'm on vacation, I'm not like, oh, hey, I'm in San Francisco. Can I get some underground... say, I want to go to the places the locals go. I'm like, my ass is like, let me see the Golden Gate Bridge. Let me see Alcatraz. Let me go to that, you know, science museum, whatever it's the Imaginarium of Dr. Parnassus, whatever it's called. Let me go down to the Embarcadero, you know? Let me go to North Bay and have the best Chipino of my entire life, right? But it is funny in Vancouver when people are looking at the steam clock and, like, it's styled as if it was built in like the 1800s. The shit was literally built in like 1972 and doesn't even run on steam. It's like it runs on kerosene or something like that. And then what's the appeal of the steam clock? Once an hour, it goes and it steam comes out of it. That's it. That's one of Vancouver's biggest tourism attractions for sure. That's why I always say, like, I think Vancouver is a nice city to visit, but if you're like, I'm going to go visit and do all this stuff, it's like, it's not really that kind of city. It's much more like, I'm going to go visit, enjoy nice weather, eat at good restaurants, enjoy the outdoors, you know, drink some good beer or something like that. It's not really a city where you're like, oh, you've got to go. And you absolutely have to go to the tallest building downtown that's not really that tall. And there's a restaurant that rotates, but the restaurant isn't that good. And it's really expensive. And it's actually like the fifth tallest building in the city.
I ain't dumb, all.
DL Guiga is crazy, man. The thing about Vancouver is realizing it's culturally important for Canada, but it's still a 2 million person city, so it's more comparable to a St. Louis or an Austin, not a San Francisco. Those big words for somebody whose airport is fucking O'Hare. Like, honestly, know your place. If you, sure, does Chicago beat Vancouver in a lot of ways? Yeah, a lot of them, without a doubt. I was going to go down some extremely offensive paths. They weren't going to be related to violence, okay? They were going to be related to, like, the pizza's not that good to justify how bad it is for you, et cetera, et cetera. But, like, let's just start with the airport, okay? Let's just load up ORD versus YVR. Anyone that's been to both that isn't from either would tell you they would rather fly into YVR, have a beautiful cup of coffee, and then, you know, get on the SkyTrain and get to their Airbnb that's destroying the property market. It's got a damn dinosaur in it. I do have to give them credit. DL Guiga is definitely, they're using their VIP badge. Using it up, maybe. YVR clears. Where else can I enjoy a Vancouver Canucks-themed restaurant? That restaurant is really bad, but it is also like one of the only places to sit down and eat in that terminal. Look, the amenities at YVR are not that great, but the logistics of the airport are fantastic. For an airport that actually serves a lot of people. It doesn't serve that many people. It serves, it's a gateway to Asia, motherfucker! Anyway. Thoughts on Peterborough? Not many. Enjoy the Havelock Country Jamboree. I bet it must have already happened, right? That must be like a June Andy. How's East Hastings? It's not good. Do not go there. As a tourist, at least. During the night? Well, I mean, like, unless you have, like, business being there, don't go there during the day either. I'm not saying you're gonna encounter, like, you know, violence or something like that, but it will probably be unpleasant for you. Yeah, fair enough. I'm not saying, like, they gotta, you know, do something about this. I'm just saying, like, it always makes me laugh when we take a cruise from Vancouver and then, like, people are staying in hotels that are, like, in the downtown east side and they're like, this whole city is messed up. And I'm like, listen. They probably should have, like, the water just happens to be next to it, okay? Like, it's... I'm sure if they could reorganize the city, they would move the cruise terminal to, like, UBC or something like that. But what's done is done. You criticize London for the same thing? No, I criticize London for, like, being a world-class city, but apparently having, like, bad food. Actually, I mean, you know, I know you probably feel safe because you're from London and I've been going off on Ohio a lot. The problem is I've actually been to London. I got a lot of bones to pick with London. Why is the food not that good? And I'm not talking about like, oh, we went out for, you know, like sushi and the sushi was bad. I'm talking about like, why when I was in London, did I eat British food? And people from England were like, you don't eat British food in London. Have you lost your mind? Like, that's crazy. And then also, why is it like $500 for a sandwich? Except at Greg's, the best restaurant I ate at in England by 7 orders of magnitude. You know, in most I can't say all, but in most parts of the world, the biggest city also has, it's at least in competition for the best food. How is it possible that in London, like, we didn't accidentally go to a good restaurant? We had to seek them out. It was like finding a needle in a haystack. And then it was like $1 million. Like, I'm not saying there's no good restaurants. I'm just saying the amount of the quality of the average food that we ate was so much lower than I would have expected from a city that has 14,000 years of history. Like, I would say, with God as my witness, I'm not saying this just to court controversy. I think that the average restaurant I've eaten at in Bellingham clears the average restaurant we ate at in London. Now, that was in 2015. So, like, maybe they've come a long way in the last few years, but...
Damn kids. Where'd they go?
I can only speak from the experience that I had, okay? I'm gonna go third floor. Bellingham has good food, it's true. I cannot tell a lie. It's pretty cool. Well, yeah, you know what? But that's not Bellingham, okay? That's a Pacific Northwest thing. I'm not giving Bellingham all that credit. I'm not even being like, oh, British food is bad. I'm saying, like, it blew my mind that we got fish and chips in London. And I was like, the fish and chips aren't that good. People were like, oh, you're in London. That's your problem. You got to go to fucking Nottingham Forest. You got to go to the Wolverham Wolves Stadium and you get a French fry sandwich that's £11.50. It's the best French fry sandwich I've ever had in my entire life. They give you a cup of gravy to drink alongside of it. Okay, wait for the gooning to stop. And then they're just standing still. This is resin. Also, someone said, don't give me that. Vancouver's like 2x2 streets big and the Chinese food wasn't even that good. Well, that's because if you want, I mean, I hate to do the London thing. If you want good Chinese food, you got to go to Richmond. There's good Chinese food in Vancouver as well, but you you should rent a car to go. Go to Richmond. You'll have some great Chinese food, I promise. That's the generator. You should talk London, but sushi isn't Canadian food. Yeah, but the sushi in Vancouver is really good. Son of a bitch. Anyone telling you the sushi in Vancouver is not good has eaten at bad places. I will defend myself from all comers on that one. Come to my city so you can go to a different city? No, don't come to my city. Honestly, you don't deserve it. You sound like you're more like... maybe London is something that's more your speed? Or Brighton? You can get some fantastic fish and chips out there, apparently. There's a guy on the seaside that sells them out of an old newspaper. Good stuff! Leatherface, we're relying on you, brother. Okay, we all dropped the ball. We all dropped the ball on that one. I'll take part responsibility for that for sure. We all dropped the ball on that one. I think I dropped the ball the most, but I was like a 40% responsible for that one. And the other two got 30 each. Someone's turning the power back on. You really game for a living? Not really. I would say I talk for a living. The gaming is like the little spoonful of sugar that helps the talking medicine go down. Gaming is very secondary here. If you want to see gaming, you go to twitch.tv/MichaelALFox. Wait 2 hours from the start of the stream until he finishes the Just Chatting segment, and then you're going to get some high-quality gaming. Here, it's just a bit of banter, mate. Malph is not a good gamer. He's just slightly better than you. I'm old. I don't derive my self-esteem from being a good gamer anymore. That's what I did when I was 16 and girls didn't want to talk to me. Now I derive my self-worth from how many plus twos I get in chat. As long as I'm getting the plus twos, I'm doing... I don't care if all four people want to escape. Now girls do want to talk to you? Well, yeah. I don't want to brag, but my wife talks to me every day. I'll just be like doing something, and then she'll be like, hey, can you go get the ladder from the garage? I'm in, bro. Hey, I got to cook. Can you look after our daughter for a bit? She fucking loves me, dude. Unprompted. I didn't even do a pickup line or anything. I'm eating a ham sandwich off of a little plate in the kitchen. She'll be like, hey, can you run out to the Home Depot and pick up some 3/8 inch screws? Yeah, maybe if you buy me dinner first. Oh, man. W Riz. It's the James Acaster bit, right? You ever hear about negging? It's when you subtly undermine someone's self-esteem to get them to like you. I was at the club, and I don't want to brag, but I was getting negged all night. It's such a good bit. It's not a bit when you're on the stage. It's a joke, but... Oh... Do you game in your spare time? I don't really. I don't. I play Super Auto Pets on my phone when there's contractors here. Otherwise, I don't. I mean, like, from Friday after Super Auto Pets gaming for YouTube until Monday's stream, there's no computer or console gaming. Father doesn't allow it. There's a little pogo for sure, but most of the pogo time, I'm just hanging out outside, you know? I'm like taking my kid for a walk in her stroller, and then I'm going zip, zip. You know what I'm saying? You don't curveball? That's me spinning a stop. Curveball's like, what about in the colder months? Well, luckily for me, I don't live in Chicago, so it doesn't get that cold here. I can still go outside. You know, the thing about Vancouver, you can hike and surf in the same day. You can do that in Chicago, too. You just got to catch an early flight from O'Hare Airport. If you leave the city by 7 or so, I'd recommend getting to the airport by approximately 2:30 a.m. Fly to Vancouver. If you get there early enough, you could do both in the same day. And then stop by Richmond for some Chinese. Well, here's the thing. Richmond's where the airport is. So you could just en route to Vancouver, you could just pick up a little Chinese food to go. Why does the family look so decrepit? Well, I think you got a point. I think that this is... the result of the beef and hot water diet. Like, they're not getting all the micronutrients that they need. I can do both in LA and both are better. Listen, DL Guiga, this one's for you. I may throw some shots at Chicago, but someone from LA talking about how much they love their city. I mean, this is a dangerous bit of rhetoric to get into. One of the only cities I've ever been to in my entire life where people were like, oh, downtown where all the buildings are? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. No, never go there. No, there's good food? No, no, no. You don't. No, no, no. There's no good food downtown. There's a great place that's 20 minutes away. Oh, okay. That 20 minutes away, that's nothing. I'll just walk. Oh, I meant 20 minutes by a spaceship. If you were to walk, it would take you 10 hours. You'd have to cross over 15 highways that don't have sidewalks. If you take a car and it's not rush hour and it's not a convention and it's not blah, 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 and the president isn't in town, then it'll take you 35 minutes to get across town. But dude, the ham sandwiches there go crazy. Would someone ever walk from Vancouver to Richmond by foot? Well, you could. You could take the Arbutus Greenway. I wouldn't walk it. That would probably be like 3 or 4 hours. But you could definitely ride a bike, and it would take you like 15 minutes entirely on separated bike lanes. Or you could pay $3.15. You could just get on the SkyTrain to drop you right off at Richmond Brig House. Just go ahead. Now in LA, what are you going to do? Uber exists, bro. Uber exists, bro. Shut the fuck up. I see you. Well, well, well. Chicago's also walkable. DL Guiga. Okay, I didn't know that, okay? They got the train. I've seen the Blues Brothers. I know Chicago has the train. It runs past everyone's apartment, right? Like the start of every movie about someone in Chicago is like they're living in an apartment and at 1 a.m. it's like... That's the generator. It also has a great bus system. I'm not coming for Chicago for anything, honestly, except that DL Guiga keeps insulting Vancouver. Like, I had nothing against Chicago except, like, you know, the Chicago Blackhawks. Otherwise, I could, as far as I'm concerned, I mean, it's probably one of the best imitation New Yorks that's out there. No, NL, we have our own culture. Al Capone, Al Capone, pizza, pizza. Tommy guns, Tommy guns, Michael Jordan, Tommy guns. I'm sorry, there's a lot of resentment built up in this bit, by the way. Toronto is a great Chicago imitation. Yeah, get their ass. I'm not saying my city's perfect. I'm just saying I live there, so I'm biased. It's crazy that like when Vancouver real estate was way more expensive than Toronto, I was like, I get it. We don't have a winter here. Now that Toronto's real estate is like the same price as Vancouver's, I'm like, your ass is really paying like Shaughnessy prices to live in Richmond Hill? Like, what are you doing? Right? You know it's fucking minus 40 in January, right? Get bonked on? Shaughnessy BTFO. Shaughnessy definitely up there as far as least favorite Vancouver neighborhoods too. Am I right, Malik? I know you're here. We don't like the Shaughnessys, do we, folks? Do we? No. I'm going to a wedding there on Saturday. Okay, well, you honestly, when you're there, Shaughnessy's the kind of place where if you're going to a wedding there, it's going to be in somebody's backyard, right? Tell me I'm right. Tell me I'm wrong. He's right! If your friends live in Fairview and they're getting married, they're like, you have to drive out to like a golf course in South Vancouver. If your friends are living in Shaughnessy, they're getting married, they're like, oh, wait, is there good parking? Yeah, don't worry. It's at my grandmother's estate. And you're like, okay, all right, I see. Will there be hors d'oeuvres? I mean, I'm jealous, honestly. Like, it sounds like it'll be a fun time. I'm not mad at you for taking advantage of it, because you, like, I'm not mad at anybody for taking advantage of it, I suppose, but, I mean, you didn't zone it for single-family housing, you know? Probably. You can make it, brother. You got this, Stam. Oh, you can't make it! Thermos. Honestly, I'm gonna turn on the car battery. He deserves to be cooked a little bit. Oh, sorry, it takes a while. I always forget, does it go... You put the red on the red and the black on the black, or the black on the red and the red on the black? How long ago was your wedding? Oh, that seems bad. Like 9 years ago? Celebrating our 10-year anniversary in 2024. It is pretty crazy to be like 34 and be married for like 10 years. That's not a very millennial-coded trait. Cover the door, cover the door, cover the door, cover the door, cover the door. She's at the Jenny. Recover Stam. She's not at the Jenny. Fake that I don't know she's here. My parents have been married for 30 years. They're 45 and 51. Yeah, but they're old. No disrespect. So old people did. Wait, 45? Hang on, you're right. Somehow in my head, I was like, your mom got married when she was 25. But she didn't. She got married when your dad was 21. It's a decidedly different situation. That's a generator? I mean, I feel like we got this one pretty locked down. I've been married for 3 years and I'm 25. Listen, it's not a contest, all right? It's just... Good congrats, good for you. It was a different time, Andy's, when it wasn't that different of a time. Plus two. Thank you, thank you. I love my wife. Based me too. Hey, I would choose this guy's wife. You know what I'm saying, Redditors? I would also choose this guy's wife. Classic bit. Really? This is obviously the generator. Oh, wow, okay. Any tips for someone getting married next year? No, honestly, like, I'm not trying to gatekeep, but it doesn't really change your life, except from, like, a legality standpoint. If you're having a kid in, like, 3 months, yeah, there's a little bit of action items I would put on the to-do list. But if you're just getting married, you're just, like, you know... I'll have a kid in 3 months. You can start your own stream, DL Guigo, okay? Oh, I live in Chicago. I ride the Peloton. I'm having a kid in 2 months. The Vancouver seawall is an underutilized piece of real estate. No, it's not. I see people on it every day. Oh, yes, it is. Let me link you to this video essay by one guy. Come on, man. Like, it's just... You what? You're Chicago NL. Okay, we should slash marker because we got London in like a few minutes. Slash marker. End of T. TCSM.